Good morning to all. Today we have to know about the role of vamp fungi in disease management. Vamp fungi come under the mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza are mutualistic symbiotic association formed between the roots of higher plant and fungi. First of all, we have to know about what is meant by mutualistic symbiotic association. Mutualistic symbiotic association means mutually they may help to each other between the roots of the higher plant and the fungi. The mycorrhiza come from the word Greek. Mykes means mushrooms or fungi. Rhiza means root. The fungi root was discovered by German botanist G.A. Frank in 1985. The main role of mycorrhiza is to convert insoluble form of phosphate present in the soil into soluble form because the plant easily may uptake. Types of mycorrhiza on the basis of morphological and anatomical features. Mycorrhiza are divided into three types: ectomycorrhiza, endomycorrhiza, ectendomycorrhiza. Endomycorrhiza are further classified into five types: vamp fungi. The full form of vamp fungi means Ardhana vesicular obsicular mycorrhizae. Archoid mycorrhiza, monotropoid mycorrhiza, ericoid mycorrhiza, orbitoid mycorrhiza. First of all, we have to know about what is meant by ectomycorrhiza. When the fungi present on the surface of the root, it may penetrate into the, not penetrate into the cell, it may penetrate between the cells. It may produce the hyphae between the cells. It is known as ectomycorrhiza. Endomycorrhiza. What is meant by endomycorrhiza? When the fungi present on the surface of the root, it may produce their hyphae in between the, not in between the cell, into the cell. It may penetrate into the cell. So it may be called as endomycorrhiza. Ectendomycorrhiza. It is similar to that of endomycorrhiza and it also penetrates in between the cell also. The fungi belonging to Vesidomycotina family. It may come under both gymnosperm and angiosperm plants. What is meant by vamp fungi? Full form of vamp fungi, vesicular or vesicle mycorrhiza. The fungi formed vamp association with the plants may belonging to Acidomyces, Vesidomyces, Zygomyces. The vamp fungi are mostly called as obligate biotopes because it completely depends on the plant for their survival. Development of mycorrhizae host plant symbiosis. First of all, we have to know how the plants may uptake nutrients from the vamp fungi and the plants may supply nutrients to the vamp fungi for their growth. It involves two stages, asymbiotic stages and symbiotic stages. What is meant by asymbiotic stages? So, asymbiotic means the absence of host, it may live for some days. It's known as asymbiotic. Symbiotic means the mutualistic relationship. Symbiotic stage occurs three phases: pre-symbiotic, early symbiotic, mature symbiotic. Those things, what may happen? Now we have this. Symbiotic phase. Pre-symbiotic phase, response of fungi to plant signal. Fungi produce some response to the plant. Response of plants to fungi signal. Plants produce transpiration to give fungi some signal. Early symbiotic. Upper psorium development, the fungi settle on the top surface of the roots, it may produce upper psorium and may penetrate into the root cell. Penetration of AM fungi. Mature symbiotic, obstacles develop. Due to the obstacles, it may transfer the nutrients in between them. Nutrients transfer, it may occur in those steps. See this picture, when the fungi settle on the surface, it may produce upper psorium. And may, it may develop and may produce orbicicles and produce vesicles. The overall view of VM fungi into the root cells, how they develop. Role of VM fungi. We have to see the picture how the plants may grow without VAM fungi and with VAM fungi. With VAM fungi, the main advantages are that to increase the resistance of foliar pathogen, increase drought tolerance, increase soil tolerance and supply nutrients to the plant. Vamp fungi symbiotic association. Orbicular. The role of orbiculars in symbiotic association. It transfer mineral nutrients from fungi. Transfer sugar from host to plant. The two transformation may occurs due to the orbicular. Vesicles is a storage organ. It's just to store the nutrients. Example, phosphorus, phospholipids, it may mainly store. Now we have to see about the role of vamp fungi. Increase nutrients uptake of plant. Nutrients, phosphorus nutrients and other elements also, nitrogen, potassium, magnesium, copper, zinc, boron, molybdenum, iron, etc. Increases diversity of the plant and to increase the yield of the plant. Produce uniform seedlings. And to improve the nutrients recycling, it may occur. Improve the tolerance of soil, soil chemical constraint. Increase plant resistance to disease and to resistance to drought. Stimulate the growth of beneficial microorganism. Now we have to see about how they may support the soil structure. Stable soil aggregate, high field polysaccharide and aggregate. Increase absorption of phosphate, uptake of zinc, uptake of water, uptake of sulfur from the soil. Increase the concentration of cytokinin and chloroplast in the plant. They protect plant during stress condition. Due to the vamp fungi, it may reduces the stress of the plant and also the reduces the heat of the soil. There are many advantages of vamp fungi and some of the disadvantages also is here. The vamp fungi, when the apply vamp fungi, when there is the presence chemical ones such as chemical pesticides, insecticides, anything, it cannot dominate over to grow there. They may suppress it because it's biofertilizer. We have to see the picture. This is a vamp. Vamp powder form. See the roots with vamp and the application of vamp and without vamp. See the plants. The growth of the plants with vamp and without vamp. Thank you.